Director Mueller, let's go to a fourth episode of obstruction of justice in the form of witness tampering, which is urging witnesses not to cooperate with law enforcement, either by persuading them or intimidating them. Witness tampering is a felony punishable by 20 years in prison. You found evidence that the president engaged in efforts, and I quote, to encourage witnesses not to cooperate with the investigation. Is that right?
That's correct. Do you have a citation?
I'm page 7 on volume 2.
Thank you.
Now, one of these witnesses was Michael Cohen, the president's personal lawyer, who ultimately pled guilty to campaign violations based on secret hush money payments to two women the president knew, and also to lying to Congress about the hoped-for $1 billion Trump Tower deal. After the FBI searched Cohen's home, the president called him up personally, he said, to check in and told him to, quote, hang in there and stay strong. Is that right? Do you remember finding that?
If it's in the report as stated, yes, it is right.
Yes. Also in the report, actually, are a series of calls made by other friends of the president. One reached out to say he was with the boss in Mar-a-Lago, and the president said he loves you. His name is redacted. Another redacted friend called to say the boss loves you, and a third redacted friend called to say everyone knows the boss has your back. Do you remember finding that sequence of calls?
Generally, yes.
When the news, and in fact, Cohen said that following the receipt of these messages, I'm quoting here, page 147 of volume 2, he believed he had the support of the White House if he continued to toe the party line, and he determined to stay on message and be part of the team. That's at page 147. Do you remember generally finding that?
Generally, yes.
Well, Robert Costello, a lawyer close to the president's legal team, emailed Cohen to say, quote, you are loved, they are in our corner, sleep well tonight, and you have friends in high places. And that's up on the screen, page 147. You remember reporting that. Okay. Now, when the news first broke that Cohen had arranged payoffs to Stormy Daniels, Cohen faithfully stuck to this party line. He said that publicly that neither the Trump Organization nor the Trump campaign was a party to the transaction, and neither reimbursed him. Trump's personal attorney at that point quickly texted Cohen to say, quote, client says thank you for what you do. Mr. Mueller, who is the capital C client thanking Cohen for what he does?
I can't speak to that.
Okay, the assumption in the context suggests very strongly it's President Trump.
I can't speak to that.
Okay. Cohen later broke and pled guilty to campaign finance offenses and admitted fully they were made, quote, at the direction of candidate Trump. Do you remember that?
Yes.
After Cohen's guilty plea, the president suddenly changed his tune towards Mr. Cohen, didn't he?
I would say I rely on what's in the report.
Well, he made the suggestion that Cohen family members had committed crimes. He targeted, for example, Cohen's father-in-law and repeatedly suggested that he was guilty of committing crimes, right?
Generally accurate.
Okay. On page 154, you give a powerful summary of these changing dynamics. And you said, I'm happy to have you read it, but I'm happy to do it if not.
I have it in front of me. Thank you.
Would you like to read it?
I would.
Can you read it out loud to everybody?
I would be happy to have you read it out.
Okay, very, very. We'll read it at the same time. The evidence concerning this sequence of events could support an inference that the president used inducements in the form of positive messages in an effort to get Cohen not to cooperate and then turn to attacks and intimidation to deter the provision of information or to undermine Cohen's credibility once Cohen began cooperating.
I believe that's accurate.
Okay. And in my view, if anyone else in America engaged in these actions, they would have been charged with witness tampering. We must enforce the principle in Congress that you emphasize so well in the very last sentence of your report, which is that in America, no person is so high as to be above the law. I yield back, Mr. Chairman. Yeah.